much. You're welcome. My name is Meta Saidi. I am Extension Agriculture Officer for HICOT, implementing the NUR project. This is Kuluba Sub-County. In Kuluba, I work in Nyoke, Nyambere, and Oraba Parishes. But currently, we are in Oraba Parish. This group is called Jonyanita Farmer Group. The group has 30 members, 20 females and 10 males. This is their demonstration. They planted the longe 5 as the strategic crop. And as you can see here in the field, we use the spacing of 75 by 60. And we have 2 plants per hole. This demonstration was planted in the 20th of August this year, 2020. So as you can see, the maize is doing well, but before that, we had challenges of fall armyworms. If you came during that time of infestation, you could not see this field with the 2 hands, with the 2 eyes, but rather, we really embarked on the major CSA, Climate Smart Agriculture Practices, of early weeding, which somehow reduced the population of the worms. Then we also embarked on using the sand. For example, each member was tasked to come with a basin of sand when the maize was at knee height. So the spots where we saw some signs of fallen worm, we were dropping the sand into the kernels of this maize. So how did this sand help the maize? That you can see that they are now doing well. This sand, when the sand hits signs, you find the sand now will become to catch some heat and it begins to burn the eggs of these worms. Then when this worm is also moving inside, twisting itself because it has a soft body, you find it also breaks. By the end of the day, you find this worm is already dead. So we came and see this field after like 1 week. We saw some great difference. Then in the between, we also came with the soil and water conservation structures. As you can see, these are trenches. These trenches are actually one of the best climate smart agriculture practices. Because maize is a crop which needs a lot of water, so we dug these trenches with the farmers. This trench is dug at 3 meters, then we left like 1 foot from one trench to the other, so that water which is harvested here, when it is full, it runs here, it seeps slowly into the other trench. So what does it mean? It means if we can receive only rain once in a week, it can be important to help this garden for more than 2 weeks. Because water which is harvested here does not go anywhere. It sinks down to the soil, back into the field. So that's why these maize are probably doing like this, especially at the tasseling stage when they are now putting these cobs, they really need a lot of water. So as you can see here, these are soil and water conservation structures. And this is what really we are encouraging farmers to do. Because we are in a very delicate season of climate change, where sometimes it can rain and you will not know when the next rain will come. So with these water harvesting structures, this water can be in position to help the maize for a longer period of time in the field. And as I told you, we were using the sand to control the armyworm. Then this garden was weeded timely. Each other time we saw weeds with the farmers will come, and they really weed their garden. And I've taken them through several trainings like farmer institution development. That's why probably they're cooperative. They understand the strength and the weaknesses of their group through the farmer institution development training. We have also done some training of pest and disease identification practical in the field. We have moved around these corners of the field for identification of this pest and disease practically. That is what we call AESA, agroecology system analysis. As I talk now, I'm very happy that the farmers now have some knowledge. I think, as you can see also, their knowledge is implicated by their field. I think their field is doing well. Thank you very much.